Praise the Lord, precious saints. Well, this very day, we're going to do a prayer to come against all negative thoughts, all negative imaginations. Hallelujah. Because the Bible tells us, according to Romans 12, verse 2, it says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable, perfect will of God. So God wants to transform our minds, because according to Psalm 119 verses 113, I hate vain thoughts, by thy law do I love. Hallelujah. And the Bible also says that God's made a way of escape for us through those thoughts. According to 1 Corinthians 10:13, no temptation has overtaken you except such as is common to man, but God is faithful, who will not allow you to be tempted beyond what you are able, but with the temptation will also make a way of escape, that you may be able to bear it. Hallelujah. That is God's will. God wants us to be able to be overcomers, overcomers in all things. And Romans 12, 21 says, do not overcome of evil, but overcome evil with good. Hallelujah. So the way we're going to overcome evil is by doing good. And it's the same with our thoughts, because the truth is, you can't stop thoughts that come to your mind. It's like a bird flying over your head. You can't stop it from flying over your head, but you can stop it from laying a nest, one twig at a time, one stick at a time on your heads. And that represents the imaginations, because the truth is, there is one battle that some people go through that no one will ever know about. It is so dark in some people's minds, so horrific, that not one word would be spoken to even their spouse, their pastor, or even their closest friend to clue them in on such a battle that that person is going through. And that battle is the battle against bad thoughts. So many Christians will also tell you that really, that battle never started until they became a Christian. Because like cancer, cancer can be dormant until it manifests. And so it is. There are certain demonic forces that are coming against us that don't want to see us to come into that truly renewed and transformed mind, according to Romans 12, verse 2. We need to come into the mind of Christ. So there is everything against you, every force of hell that is working against some people to stop them from coming into that fullness that there is in Christ Jesus. So what I mean by bad thoughts is unwanted, intrusive thoughts. So of course, we can see according to Genesis 6 verse 5 that God saw that the wickedness of man was so great in the earth that even every imagination of his thoughts, of his heart, was only evil continually. So we can see that according to scripture, it says that God, you know, sent the flood because he saw the wickedness of man's hearts, the wickedness of the imaginations. So, but what we're going to talk about here also, we're going to talk about those deep, dark things. You know, I always say to people, you are who you really are when you're by yourself. So when you're by yourself, those thoughts that are coming against you, the thoughts against others, and whatever it is, whatever those imaginations are that you're dealing with. And the only thing that one most minds is that particular issue, that issue of dealing with thoughts. Hallelujah. So that's what we're going to talk about today. So imagine being in a room and there is no escape out of this particular room. The only thing in this room is a radio, and on that radio they are playing music with the most blasphemous, most horrific words imaginable. And you try to change the channel on the radio, but the radio has no dial on it. You try to smash it on the ground, but it is nailed to the wall so you can't even move it. You try to kick it to destroy it, but it is made out of metal. You sleep and you hear it. You wake up and you hear it. You eat and you hear it. Day in and day out, this radio is playing, and there is absolutely no relief whatsoever. So that is what it is like to live with intrusive, unwanted thoughts. Now, maybe you don't struggle so much with this, but there are some people that struggle with it to a greater degree. So there is the most horrific words and images imaginable that one could possibly try to get rid of, but they can't. They are invincible to anything that you throw at them until you come into the fullness of Christ to understand your authority. But they are there day in and day out. There is almost no rest from its torment. And sometimes you wonder if it's really you who is putting those thoughts there. You wonder if it's the devil. You really are never sure sometimes. Some of those people say, is this me? Is this me? But you feel the most intense and horrific guilt, and there is just nothing you can do to stop these things. And that is what the enemy would want you to think. And we can also see that, you know, even the doctors would diagnose this as even, you know, obsessive compulsive disorder. Because one of the most painful elements of that particular disorder is the intrusive thoughts that many people with OCD experience. So these involuntary thoughts or images become obsessions. The main features of intrusive obsession thoughts are that they are automatic, frequent, upsetting, or distressing, and are difficult to control and get rid of. And some of those compulsive or intrusive thoughts include repetitive blasphemous thoughts. Thoughts about impulsively saying blasphemous words or committing blasphemous acts while attending any type of Christian service, or intrusive sexual thoughts that even about other saints, about other, even God himself. There are some people that struggle with those thoughts that are coming to them more than once. So intrusive bad thoughts or images that occur during your prayer, during your meditation, or any other observances in a revival meeting, wherever it is, contaminated things, and they're trying to ruin or cancel out the value of that particular meeting that you're attending. Or maybe your thoughts are not that bad, but the walk around you and the thinking, you know, maybe you're thinking of yourself as being defeated or a failure or unworthy or unlovable. Whatever those thoughts are, and whatever level it is, we call it the battle of the mind. And you can hear more about that teaching, which I'll make available for you to click on, the battle of the mind. So many sometimes see themselves that, you know, because of past hurts or abuse, or because something that they had hoped for just did not work out that way that they had planned, or because they feel less than others around them, that is also a way that these thoughts come to manifest in our mind. So the problem is, once you see yourself that way, you will speak of yourself that way. And what that does is condemns you to a life of negativity. It is a cycle that will perpetuate and continue. So this is what I mean. So whenever we activate negative thoughts and words, we create a pigeonhole that keeps us trapped in that negative spiral. So the truth is, negative thinking is destructive. It drains your energy and stops you from moving forward and engaging in positive activities. It leaves you feeling badly and locks you into believing that you do not deserve more or even better. And the Bible tells us, according to Proverbs 18:21, it says the tongue has the power of life and death. So the same is true of negative words. It has power. So we can see that this particular tongue that we speak and the thoughts, they speak out positive or negative things. So when we say harmful words or belittle children, they would cry and they would cower. So very few see it as a call to toughen up and to be better than whatever you professed them to be. So in some ways, it will drain. It drains the body and it goes into the mind, and there it creates a harmful situation. So when we say harmful words, our brains and bodies cry and cower. Rather than shine and become all that God has lovingly ordained us to be that can happen when we are given positive words. So instead of negative words or thoughts, try positive thoughts and utterances. Replace negative thoughts and words with what God is saying. And we've done a lot of prayers on that, you know, decreeing and declaring, you know, binding and loosening, all these different prayers that I've done that you can also find in the link above will help you with this. But the fact is that we can see that you know, if we want to be prosperous in our thinking, you know, we must learn to say what God is saying in the light of His word. Because according to Psalm 119 verse 105, it says, "The word of God is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path, and it will lead you through all darkness. It is alive and active," according to Hebrews 4:12, "and will give you life and keep you from going even when you feel low. It is a weapon," according to Hebrews 4 verse 12 and also Ephesians 4 verse 17. "It is sharper than a two-edged sword," hallelujah, "and will cause you to bounce forward regardless of the depths of the struggle that you're facing." So moreover, the word of God says wonderful things about us being children of God, and these very words give life and they are words that we should choose to believe. For example, one of our, you know, favorite verses would be 1 Peter 2:9. So here the Apostle Peter is explaining what God says about his people. He is sharing with them how they differ from the rest of the world. He said, "But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, God's special possession." Imagine this. Chosen people means God chose you, not the other way around. And He chose you for great and lovely things. Hallelujah. That's why the Bible says in Jeremiah 29:11, it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." Hallelujah. So God wants to do that. And according to, you know, 1 Peter 2:9 also says that you are God's special possession. So according to the dictionary, it tells us that the word special means being in some way superior, held in particular esteem or readily distinguishable from others of the same category, designed for a particular purpose or occasion. So God says that about you. And as God's possession, He has the responsibility to take care of you. He is your source for all things. In other words, He's not just money or a shoulder to cry on when things start to get super rough, but you can speak to Him daily and He will reply to you. And His reply will show love, compassion, unmerited favor and grace of truth, like all fathers, like a good father who will also discipline, but that discipline, if you heed, makes you stronger and better off in the future. So there is more. The Bible also will always, through scripture of affirmation, show you that He's affirming how God sees you and how He, what He says about you also. So the thing that it is personalized scripture that will speak aloud over your life daily. So the importance of speaking scripture is so important. But the truth is, many of us are coming under attack from these negative thoughts. So we're going to pray, we're going to bind these thoughts, and we're going to come against the enemy right now that is contaminating you with those thoughts. So Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I praise Your holy name. Lord, give us strength today, dear Lord, to withstand the works of the devil as he tries to seep into our minds. We rebuke his negativity, every negativity thought, in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray that You will cover us under the precious blood of the Lamb as You, O Lord, infiltrate our minds, our bodies, and our souls. Guard us from and in Your divinity, so that the negative thoughts that arise would be blocked by Your and our unbreakable faith in You, Lord Jesus. We thank You for Philippians 4:8 says, "Finally, brothers It says whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, where there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, we think about these things. See, the Word of God tells us to think about positive things. So, Heavenly Father, shield us so that the enemy has no way to enter in. We request that the Holy Spirit's presence be thrusted upon our lives as He guides our thoughts in the direction of positive thinking. Change our thought patterns. Oh Lord, our God, Lord, to be focused on You. Allow our minds to be focused on You and on Your promises. Lead us into a plain path and restore our souls. According to Proverbs 17:14, the beginning of strife is like letting out water. So quiet before the quarrel breaks out. So, Heavenly Father, we pray today that Jesus, You are the Prince of Peace. Enable us with Your tranquility and love so that our mind may be at ease. Break every chain of negative thoughts as we speak forth prosperity and positively into our life. For our life, Lord, is life in You, and You are abundance to us, and there is power in the tongue. So therefore, we declare and decree that every stronghold in our life produced by negative thought patterns be broken today in the name of Jesus Christ. We give You thanks, our Heavenly Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We need Your protection, dear Lord, from every evil force that would rise up against us. We give us the strength today, Lord, that we may be able to stand against the works of the devil as he tries to seep into our minds. We break every chain of negativity thoughts in Jesus' mighty name. We declare and decree that today every stronghold in our life produced by negative thoughts or patterns are broken in Jesus' mighty name. If God be with us, who can be against us? Heavenly Father, we pray today, every bad thoughts occupying our mind, we will flush it out now by the blood of Jesus Christ. Every evil thoughts that want to ruin our life and destroy it, You cannot hold us captive. Release us, and You will die now in Jesus' mighty name. We receive a clean and godly thoughts today in the name of Jesus Christ. We destroy any unclean powers using our mind as their habitation for manipulation in Jesus' mighty name. Any evil thoughts of depression fade away by fire in the name of Jesus Christ. We reject every evil thoughts and every thoughts from the pit of hell, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Every arrow of the devil that has attacked our mind, go back to the sender in Jesus' mighty name. Our mind begin to receive heavenly advice and instruction in Jesus' mighty name. Every altar of anger ruling the affairs of our life, we set up a blaze by fire and by thunder in Jesus' mighty name. We bind right now every force of the enemy right now. We cast down the spirit of uncertainty in our minds. And today we render its activity null and void in the name of Jesus Christ. Every natural hatred against our friends and others for no reason, we cancel them by the blood of Jesus Christ. Any problem that we are facing that is strengthening the habitat or the habit of bad and evil thoughts, be terminated in Jesus' name. Any power that would want to use our mind as an avenue to destroy us, you are a bastard and you will receive double calamity in the name of Jesus Christ. We seal off the entrance and exit door of our mind against evil thoughts in the name of Jesus Christ. We cancel every evil or bad thoughts others or helpers had about us in the name of Jesus Christ. We break authority right now of every evil domination over our mind and spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Every evil imagination against others be destroyed in Jesus' mighty name. Our mind, we command you to think right in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, strengthen us and our inner man and to bring forth Your fire and Your power in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, we uproot every hidden tree or evil tree in our mind in the name of Jesus Christ. Our Father, Plant your love in us in the name of Jesus Christ. We break the power of darkness having negative influence over our life and negativity in Jesus' mighty name. Remote control powers directing us to do any evil against our fellow ones, clear away by fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Every negative expectations of wicked over us be rendered null and void in the name of Jesus Christ. Our minds will not push us to death and destruction in Jesus' mighty name. Every habitation of witchcraft in our mind, clear away in Jesus' mighty name. Hear the word of the Lord and be delivered from evil thoughts in the name of Jesus Christ. We cancel and nullify every evil thought of darkness in the name of Jesus Christ. We shall not think evil thoughts against us in Jesus' mighty name. Every evil power today assigned to pollute our minds backfire in Jesus' mighty name. Our mind, we control you today under the power of Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Godly thoughts fill our minds and in Jesus' mighty name, and remove every burden and lift it off our shoulders today in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bind and rebuke any demon that will try or has tried to succeed to disturb our peaceful living by damaging our priorities and good living, great health, and sound sleep and sound reputation from us and our families in Jesus' mighty name. We command you to go from our lives right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Release in the name of Jesus Christ. Release every evil misfortune be released, and we command you to let go of any type of hardship caused by you, natural or in the unnatural or supernatural. Circumcised right now, remove in the name of Jesus Christ anything coming against our financial hardships, emotional battles, spiritual burdens, frustrations caused by you right now. You will leave in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we ask for healing, an abundance of blessings and miracles to reinstate where it's been lost and regain confidence in God and His people, and to live peacefully without the fear of people's evil thoughts, words, deeds, and any bad spirits coming against us in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, we bind right now each one and every opportunity that will never be able to succeed in the future. We have overcome through the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. We bind and rebuke any evil spirit and misfortune that would try to come against our prayer for the goodness of our souls, our sound finance, our great health, and our peaceful living in Jesus' mighty name. We pray and command that everyone or any spirit who causes trouble will never come back to hurt us or anyone else in the name of Jesus Christ, and take anything from anyone, Lord, never come back to our lives as thieves or blasphemer, and nature's wrath come upon you in Jesus' mighty name. Father, help us, Lord, to renew our minds today. We claim and proclaim the richness of our spiritual life here on earth as it is in heaven. We claim and proclaim today peace and contentment and true happiness from within. We claim and proclaim freedom from fear of the unknown. We claim and proclaim complete confidence and dependence on God, and we will triumph in life without the evil works, thoughts, and doings. We claim and proclaim that we will all live with the abundance of God's provisions and claims as wealthy children of God who inherited His choicest blessings of salvation for our souls in Jesus' mighty name. We claim and proclaim that we are accepting Jesus as our Lord and Savior, and through baptism we have become sons and daughters of the Father and brothers in Christ Jesus and rightful heirs to the kingdom of heaven. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, for your love. And we thank you, Holy Spirit, for empowering us to be aggressive against Satan and his evil spirits. We thank you, Jesus, for setting us free. And we thank you for every power that is setting us free today. Lord Jesus, fill us with your charity, compassion, faith, gentleness, hope, humility, joy, kindness, light, love, mercy, modesty, patience, peace, purity, security, tranquility, trust, truth, understanding, and wisdom. Help us to walk in your light and truth, illuminated by the Holy Spirit, so that we work together and we praise and honor and glorify our Father in times of eternity. And for you, Lord Jesus, because you are the way, the truth, and the life, according to John 14, verse 6, and according to John 10:10, you have come that we might have life and life more abundant. Father, our heavenly hosts, we believe and we accept that all your will be done according to our lives, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And according to Isaiah 12, verse 2, God indeed is our Savior, and we are confident and we are unafraid. Our strength and courage is in the Lord, and He has been our Savior. Hallelujah. So the Bible says, and we're going to speak these affirmations right now, according to Ephesians 3, verse 17, I am rooted and established in love. According to 3 John verse chapter 2, it says, my soul will prosper. According to Jeremiah 29:11, I will prosper. According to Psalm 139 verse 14, I am fearfully and wonderfully made. According to John 15 verse 5, I will bear much fruit. According to Deuteronomy 28:13, I am the head and not the tail. According to Deuteronomy 28:13, I am above and not beneath. According to Genesis 12 verse 3, I am a blessing. According to Luke 1:28, I am blessed and highly favored. According to Psalm 45 verse 2, my words are anointed. According to 1 Corinthians 2:16, I have the mind of Christ. According to Ephesians 2 verse 6, I am seated in heavenly places. According to John 16:27, God loves me. According to Proverbs 31, I am what I say, what you say that I am, Lord. According to 1 Corinthians 3:19, I have godly wisdom. According to Isaiah 62:3, I am royalty. According to Romans 6:11, I am alive in Christ. According to Isaiah 54 verse 17, no weapons formed against me shall prosper. According to 2 Timothy 1:7, I have not given you a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and of a sound mind. According to Job 22:23, I am restored. According to Isaiah 40 verse 31, I am renewed. According to 1 John 2:27, I am anointed of God. According to 2 Corinthians 5:17, I am a new creature. According to Galatians 5:1, I am set free. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And according to 2 Corinthians 10:5, I rebuke every thought and take every thought captive under the obedience of Christ right now. Hallelujah. Obedience to Christ there means that we should submit and conform what the Bible says. Hallelujah. What does the Bible say? The Bible tells us to be obedient because obedience is better than sacrifice. Hallelujah. So I just want to finish off by saying this. You know, I heard of a man that completely renewed his mind just from miraculously reading the book of Psalms. Hallelujah. The book of Psalms has a lot of power because we can see that it's a relationship between God and the psalmist. Hallelujah. So it is an opportunity for you to confess out God's word that is true to you. The Bible says in Isaiah 26 verse 3, it says, you will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed upon you. So those that keep the peace in the Lord, they will be mindful of what God is saying. The Bible says in Philippians 4 verse 6 and 7, it says, be anxious for nothing, but in all things through prayer with supplication and thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, that the peace of God that surpasses all understanding would guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. May you be blessed today as the Lord blesses you. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrow Path Ministries in Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom.